taken the numerical examples. So let us continue with certain numerical examples, numerical problems, out of which the most important, some of the problems we are taking over here. It is the problem number 4 in your book. The density of iridium is 22.4 gram per centimeter cube. The unit cell of iridium is FCC, face center cube. Calculate the radius of iridium atom. Given molar mass of iridium is 192.2 gram per mole. See, for solving all these problems of the solid state, one important expression we have studied. That important expression I am repeating over here once again. We have studied that if we consider lead, A is the edge length. If A is the edge length, then therefore volume of cube will be equal to A cube, because we know for the cube three sides, length, width and height are same. They are termed as edge, and A is the edge length. Therefore volume of the cube will be equal to A cube. Further, if we consider, we have to calculate the mass of unit cell. Mass of unit cell will be equal to mass of one particle multiplied by mass of number of the particles. So let m is the mass of one particle. Whenever it is multiplied by n, n is the number of particles present in that unit cell. Therefore mass of unit cell will be the product of m into n, where small m is nothing but the mass of one particle and n will be the number of particles. So this product m into n will give us the mass of unit cell. Now we know the formula of density. We know that density will be equal to mass of unit cell divided by volume of unit cell. Density of unit cell, rho, is equal to the ratio of mass of unit cell to the volume of unit cell, this ratio. Now mass of unit cell we know, it is m into n divided by volume of unit cell, that also we know, it is equal to a cube. So substituting the values, we will get rho, density will be equal to mass of unit cell, that is m into n divided by volume of unit cell, a cube. Now here we have to substitute the value for m, that is mass of one particle. That can be calculated using the Avogadro's concept. According to that concept, we know that molar mass of substance capital M, it is equal to mass of one particle, or maybe mass of one atom, into Avogadro's number multiplied by Avogadro's number. Therefore molar mass M will be equal to mass of one particle, one atom. What is the mass of one particle or one atom? That is equal to small m multiplied by Avogadro's number n a. For this n a, we know that it has a value 6.022 into 10^23. From this equation, what is the mass of one atom? What is the mass of one particle? It is m is equal to capital M divided by n a. Now let this is equation number 2 and this is equation number 1. Substituting for this m in equation 1 from equation 2, we know the value of small m, it is equal to capital M upon n a. If we replace this m by capital M upon n a, we will get this equation as rho density will be equal to small n, this one, divided by p means a cube, this one. And what is the value for m? It is equal to capital M divided by n a. This equation gives the relationship between density, molar mass, Avogadro number, volume of the cube and number of particles present in the cube. N is nothing but this small n, it is important. Small n is known as number of particles present in that cube, unit cell. Na is Avogadro's number. So this relation is important in order to solve all these problems. So now let us continue with the problem number 4. The density of iridium is going to be 2.41, means rho is given. The unit cell of iridium is FCC, face centered cube. Then calculate the radius of iridium atom, that is nothing but R we have to find out, and molar mass of iridium is given at 192.2 gram per mole. So now let us solve that problem. While solving any problem, we know that first of all we have to write the given data of the problem. So what is given over here? They have given density rho, it is given as 22.4 gram per centimeter cube. Then the structure is, unit cell is FCC, face center cube, having how many number of particles present? It is equal to 4 particles are present. 4 particles are present. Then we have to calculate the radius of iridium. Radius means R we have to calculate, and molar mass of iridium is given, means capital M. It is given as equal to 192.2 gram per mole. This is the data given, and we have to find out the radius. So first of all, using the expression which just now I have told you, it is that expression for rho density will be equal to N capital M divided by a cube multiplied by n a, Avogadro's number. Using this equation, what we can find out? We can find out the value of a, because this equation can also be written like this. If we take a cube over here and rho can be shifted over here, so one and the same. A cube is nothing but volume, n is number of particles, n is molar mass, rho density, and n a Avogadro's number. So from this we can calculate the volume a cube, and from a cube we can calculate the value of a, that is a strength we can calculate. So let us substitute the value. N a cube will be equal to n is number of particle 4 multiplied by m molar mass 192.2 divided by density 22.4 multiplied by Avogadro's number 6.022 into 10^23. So on solving this, we will get a cube is equal to multiplication of this 4 to the 8 point. Again 4 to the 8. 4 9 are 36. 4 1 are 4 plus 3. 4 3 7. So what is it? 4 to the 8. Again 4 to the 8. 4 9 are 36. 3 is carried. 4 1 are 4 plus 3 7 68.8 divided by this factor. If these two factors are multiplied, we will get the value equal to 134.8928. This will be 134.8928. 10^23 at denominator, at numerator it will become 10^-23. And if we solve this, how to solve this? Log of numerator minus log of denominator and then anti-log. Here if we solve this like this, anti-log of log of numerator minus log of denominator, this over here 10^-23, forget it, that is the factor over there as it is, 10^-23. If we solve this value, log of numerator minus log of denominator and then anti-log, we will get a cube, that is hallum, and that answer comes equal to 5.6993. The answer on solving this will be 5.6993. This one multiplied by 10^-23. So this is about a cube. Means hallum we have calculated. Now this hallum must be converted into age length. A we have to calculate. From this equation, what is the equation for A now? A will be equal to cube root of 5.6993 into 10^-23. Here now, little bit modification we have to take. We have to do the little bit modification because this is the cube root. Cube root. So how to solve this? It is 10^-23. Raised to here 10^-23. Raised to 1/3. So 3 and 23 are not in the table. So this must be converted either to 21 or 24 so that this figure is in a table of 3. And for simplicity, always convert this 23 to 24, not 21. For simplicity, we have to convert this factor to 24, not 21. So if this will be 24, what will happen? A will be equal to cube root of 56.993 into 10^-24. And the further solution, we know it is done like this. A is equal to 1/3 log of 56.993 into 10^-24 raised to 1/3. If we solve this, the log of this term divided by 3,
the log of 56. We have to take there the log of
56.993, the characteristic is 1. Characteristic will be 1. Point. The log of 56 in 99, that is equal to 7558. 1/3 means this is divided by 3 multiplied by this will be now 10⁻¹. So this is divided by 3. A is equal to, the answer comes equal to, this we have to solve. 3 5s are 15, 0. 3 5s are 15, 2 is there, 3 8s are 24, 1 is there, 3 5s are 15, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 0.5853. And now we have to see the anti-log of this term, anti-log into 10⁻¹. This we have solved completely. Now no question of observing the log of anti-log of this term, because this is, we have solved completely. Just see the anti-log of this, so that we will get A is equal to anti-log of 0.585253 will be equal to 3.848. So this will be 3.848 into 10⁻¹. A we have calculated, page length, density we have taken in centimeter, gram per centimeter cube, therefore A is in the centimeter. This is how age length can be calculated. And after calculating the age length, we have to calculate the radius. Now it is very simple to calculate the radius, because for FCC, which is the type of this structure, this is the FCC structure. And for FCC, we know that R is equal to A upon 2 root 2. This is the equation we have studied, which shows the relation between radius and age length. If we solve this factor, it comes equal to 0.35. That factor comes equal to 0.3535. Or if we substitute directly the value of A, we can calculate the radius like this. R is equal to, that is the value of A, 3.848 into 10⁻¹. 3.848 into 10⁻¹ divided by 2 root 2. Now what is the root 2 that we have to substitute here? Then log of denominator minus log of numerator. So let us see over here how to calculate that answer. Square root of 2, we know this answer, it is equal to 1.4142. Substituting there, radius R is equal to 3.848 multiplied by 10⁻¹ divided by 2 into 1.4142. Now how to solve this factor? Here we have to take the logarithm of numerator, then logarithm of denominator, their subtraction as usual, log of numerator minus log of denominator, and then anti-log, so that we will get the final answer, radius 1.3604. If we solve this, we will get the answer 1.3604 into 10⁻¹. Into 10⁻¹. Sorry. Centimeter. 1.3604 into 10⁻¹ centimeter. Or since this is centimeter, it is equal to, in the picometers, Now this can also be written 136.04 into 10 raised to minus 10 centimeter. Two decimal right side. Means what I have done? Multiplied by 100. So also divided by the 100. 10 raised to minus 10. And this is nothing but radius equal to 136 picometer. That is what the answer given in our book. This is how the problem must be solved. For the solution of problem, we must know how to eliminate the square root, how to eliminate, evaluate the cube root. That is the important type of calculation over here. And the calculations are rather performed carefully, because otherwise the subtraction of log to observe the log, to observe the antilog may cause the difficulties. It may cause the incorrect calculations. So perform the calculations carefully. This is problem number 4. Now let us see problem number 5. Now let us see here problem number 5. Aluminium crystallizes in cubic closed packed structure with unit cell edge length of 353.6 picometer. What is the radius of aluminium atom? How many unit cells are there in 1 centimeter cube of aluminium? Now let us solve this problem. The given data for this problem is the element atom given is aluminium, which has a structure of cubic closed packed, means face centered cubic structure, where one unit cell is containing 4 atoms of the aluminium. The edge length of such FCC structure is given 353.6 picometer. That is nothing but 353.6 into 10 raised to minus 10 centimeter. Picometer into centimeter, this is multiplied by 10 raised to minus 10. So this becomes 353.6 into 10 raised to minus 10 centimeter. And we have to calculate the radius of aluminium. Since the structure is FCC, face centered cubic structure, we know that for FCC structure, radius will be given by this formula, R is equal to A upon 2 root 2. We know the root 2 is equal to 1.4142 multiplied by 2. Certain factor comes here. Then 1 divided by that factor, that comes equal to 0.3535A. So R is equal to 0.3535A. Now we know the value of A, 353.6 into 10 raised to minus 10. So this factor multiplied by A, we will get radius is equal to 0.3535 into 353.6 into 10 raised to minus 10. Simply it is solved. Log of this term plus log of second term and then antilog. Answer comes equal to this one. 124.9 into 10 raised to minus 10 centimeter. Centimeter now converted to picometer. So 10 raised to minus 10 factor can be neglected now, because 1 picometer is equal to 10 raised to minus 10 centimeter. Therefore, this answer comes equal to 124.9 picometer, or simply 125 picometer. Now, we know the value calculated by the formula cube of edge length A. Volume is equal to A cube. A is given as 353.6 into 10 raised to minus 10. Substituting over here, we can calculate the value of volume. Cube of this factor, 4.42 into 10 raised to minus 23. On solving this completely, we will get this answer. Now what it means? It means that This is the volume centimeter cube. Volume in centimeter cube of aluminium FCC structure. Here one unit cell is present. Here four aluminium atoms are present. So 4.42 × 10⁻²³ centimeter cube is nothing but one unit cell. So 1 centimeter cube. They have given second calculation. Second calculation. 4.42 × 10⁻²³ centimeter cube is one unit cell. Therefore 1 centimeter cube is equal to how many unit cells? X unit cells. Doing the cross multiplication, answer of x can be calculated as x is equal to 1/4.42 × 10⁻²³ log numerator minus denominator and then anti log. We will get this answer 0.226 × 10⁻²³ at numerator become 10⁻²+23. Taking on right side one decimal. 10⁻²³ become 22 and this become 2.26. So finally x means number of unit cells in 1 centimeter cube are 2.26 × 10⁻²² This is the solution for problem number 5. Now let us see one more problem. Now see question number 3. This is the question number 3 in your book. Here problem number IX means problem number 9. The problem is copper crystallizes in FCC unit cell with edge length of 495 picometer. Copper crystallizes in FCC unit cell with edge length of 495 picometer. What is the radius of copper atom? Very simple. Just now we have studied the problem number 4 also of a same type, same manner. What is the given data for this problem? Given data, the structure is FCC. Copper crystallizes in FCC where 4 atoms of copper are present. 4 atoms of copper are present in its FCC structure. And the edge length for this FCC is given as A is equal to 495 picometer. Or A will be equal to 495 into 10⁻¹⁰ centimeter. 495 × 10⁻¹⁰ centimeter. And simply we have to calculate the value of radius R. So we know R radius for FCC has a formula A upon 2√2. We have solved this already. So R will be equal to A. A is 495 × 10⁻¹⁰ or A divided by 2 into square root of 2 is 1.4142. If we solve this, R is equal to A or it is 1/2 × 2⁴, 2⁴ × 8, again 2⁴, 2⁴ × 8, 2⁴, 1 divided by 2.8284 into A. If we solve this figure, 1 divided by 2.8284, this comes equal to 0.3535 multiplied by A. So 1 divided by 2.8284 will be equal to 0.3535, and this is A over here. Now substitute the value of A. Radius R is equal to 0.3535 35 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 495 इनटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 10. सो दिस इज द रेडियस. नाउ इन सेंटीमीटर. सो हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस? लॉग ऑफ दिस टर्म प्लस लॉग ऑफ सेकंड टर्म एंड देन एंटी लॉग. लॉग ऑफ फर्स्ट टर्म प्लस लॉग ऑफ सेकंड टर्म एंड देन एंटी लॉग. वी विल गेट द फाइनल वैल्यू, फाइनल आंसर ऑफ रेडियस आर, एंड दैट इज इक्वल टू 175. इफ वी सॉल्व दिस, दिस कम्स इक्वल टू 175 इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 10 सेंटीमीटर. सिंस 1 पिकोमीटर इज इक्वल टू 10 रेस टू माइनस 10 सेंटीमीटर, देयरफॉर रेडियस इन द पिकोमीटर विल बी इक्वल टू 175 पिकोमीटर. दिस इज हाउ द प्रॉब्लम इज सॉल्व. वेरी सिंपल. गिवन डाटा ए इज गिवन. सिंपली सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए, मल्टीप्लाई द वैल्यू ऑफ ए बाय दिस फैक्टर. लॉग ऑफ फर्स्ट टर्म प्लस लॉग ऑफ सेकंड टर्म एंड एंटी लॉग. वी विल गेट द रेडियस इन सेंटीमीटर. दैट सेंटीमीटर कन्वर्टेड टू पिकोमीटर बिकॉज वी नो 1 पिकोमीटर इज इक्वल टू 10 रेस टू माइनस 10 सेंटीमीटर. देयरफॉर रेडियस विल बी इक्वल टू 175 पिकोमीटर. सो विद दैट वी हैव सॉल्व थ्री प्रॉब्लम्स. नाउ फॉर प्रैक्टिस यू हैव टू सॉल्व द रिमेनिंग प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ द चैप्टर सॉलिड स्टेट. सो विल स्टॉप ओवर हियर.